This installment is going to talk about atoms, particularly about the nucleus of atoms and the particles that you find inside the nucleus, protons and neutrons. But first, let's remind ourselves that an atom is the smallest part of an element that we could have that has all the properties of that element. In other words, an atom of gold is the smallest piece of gold we can possibly have. Now, years ago, it was thought that the atoms were as small as it got. Nothing was smaller than an atom. They were the smallest pieces of matter possible. But we have since learned that atoms are made out of things smaller than themselves. They are made out of building blocks called protons, neutrons, and electrons. And these things are smaller than atoms because they make an atom. So we call those things subatomic particles. We're going to focus on protons and neutrons because we find them in the nucleus. We'll have another video that talks about electrons in the atom. So, again, as a quick review, the nucleus of an atom is extremely heavy compared to the rest of the atom. Every atom has a nucleus, it's in the center of the atom, and 99.9% of all the mass of an atom is located in the nucleus. It's very heavy and very tiny compared to the rest of the atom. As we mentioned in class, if the nucleus was the size of a marble, the entire atom would be the size of a football stadium like Lambeau Field. Now, like I said, we're going to focus on protons and neutrons. So let's take a look at the things we need to know first. Protons are positively charged particles in the nucleus, and neutrons are neutral, or they have no charge. It's important to remember, neutrons, no charge, protons, positive charge. Now, the number of protons in an atom is important. It determines the atom's atomic number. So if an atom has three protons, it has an atomic number of three. If an atom has seven protons, it has an atomic number of seven. I think you get the picture. The interesting thing about the atomic number is that it identifies the element. Only lithium has an atomic number of three. Only carbon has an atomic number of six. And only nitrogen has an atomic number of seven. None of the elements share a common atomic number. It doesn't happen. All the atomic numbers of all the elements on the periodic table are different. That means that all the atoms of those elements have a different number of protons. Here's a real simple atom. You can see there is the nucleus right here. Inside is positive particles, these two guys right here, and neutral particles, these two guys right here. And the nucleus then is surrounded by the electron cloud, in this case, two electrons. What type of atom is this? Take a look at the number of protons. How many protons are there? Since there are two protons, we have an atomic number of. If you said the atomic number was two, you'd be correct. And with an atomic number of two, this is a helium atom. Now, it's also important to remember that the mass number is found by taking the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. When we add those together, we come up with the mass number. So this is something people quite often get confused with. So we're going to review it here. Once again, the mass number is the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus, whereas the atomic number is just the number of protons. So make sure you know the difference. It's very important. A lot of people get that confused. Atomic number, number of protons. So an atomic number of three means three protons. A mass number of seven means that we have a total of seven protons and neutrons. Lithium has an atomic mass of seven. And since its atomic number is three, that means it has three protons and four neutrons to get a mass number of seven. We get those mass numbers by something we call AMUs, or atomic mass units. An atomic mass unit is essentially the mass of one of the particles in the nucleus of an atom. One AMU equals the mass of either one proton or one neutron. They're about the same mass. So with our lithium example, since we had 3 protons and 4 neutrons, that's a total of 7 atomic mass units, and therefore the atomic mass of lithium is 7. Let's look at this and sum it all up here now. Here's sodium. Sodium has an atomic number of 11 and a mass number of 23. Now, with our atomic number of 11, that tells us what? If you said that tells us the number of protons, you'd be correct. So how many protons are in a sodium atom? That's right, 11. Okay, now the mass number is 23. How many neutrons does sodium have? Remember, mass number is the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. Keep in mind, we have 11 protons. If we have 11 protons, how many neutrons do we have if our mass number is 23? In other words, what's the difference between 23 and 11? Difference is 12. That means we have 12 neutrons. So a sodium atom has 11 protons because its atomic number is 11, and it has 12 neutrons because the difference between the mass number and the atomic number is 12. So that gives us 12 neutrons. Many atoms have the same number of protons as they do neutrons. Others have a different number of protons as they do neutrons. You really have to look at the periodic table to determine that. So that's the nucleus, containing protons and neutrons. Our next video, we'll talk about electrons, and we'll get to that shortly. Stay tuned.